Hundreds of people right now are waiting to be evacuated from Wuhan, China, the epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak. 24 countries are scrambling to bring their citizens home. We're now beginning to see how chaotic it can be for people trying to leave Wuhan. Michael Schellenberg and his wife and son were visiting family in the area and got caught in the citywide lockdown. They sent these photos from the airport as they waited to board a Canadian charter plane out of China. Frank Hannum and his wife say that they're very grateful that they made it out on a US chartered flight. You can see passengers in their photos wearing face masks. They tell CNN that health workers in protective gear were on board the flight doing their best in a stressful situation. Joining me now is somebody who knows something about this. In the coronavirus debrief, it's Jared Evans. He's one of the dozens of Americans evacuated from Wuhan, China, and now being kept under quarantine at a US military base in California. Jared, it's really good to hear from you. I imagine you are looking for ways to fill your time, but nevertheless, great to have you on the show.
Thank you, Bianca. I appreciate it.
Tell us about how you first became aware of coronavirus when you were in Wuhan as a professional footballer, and then how you were evacuated back to California.
Yes, Bianca. So I became aware of the whole situation actually from a Chinese friend of mine. Apparently, they found it over WeChat, and he direct messaged me and said, "Hey, man, I think you have an opportunity to, you know, go home to your family. You know, read this email that he received from WeChat." So I basically just emailed the Beijing ACS, which is the consulate in Beijing, and all my information. They emailed me back, and I had to pretty much find a way to the airport. As you know, all personal vehicles were completely not allowed on the road.
And how are you feeling personally? You're not suffering from any symptoms yourself. Are you having medical checks at the base?
Yeah, so I'm not suffering from any kind of symptoms. I'm completely healthy. I haven't catched a cold in the last 3 years. But yeah, we're getting basic your medical checks every single day, twice a day. And we're just pretty much just waiting for our release form.
And are you able to mingle and interact with other people that are also quarantined on the base? How are you all spending your days?
Yeah, so I'm personally spending my day, you know, taking care of my body, working out. But there's all different types of activities on the base. You know, people are playing cards, dominoes, Zumba classes, boxing classes. I mean, there's art classes, learning how to do your taxes. And we're just trying to, you know, keep as much, busy as much as possible.
And are they putting on these classes and activities for you, like learning how to do your taxes and cards and exercise?
Yeah, so whoever wants to join is capable of joining. Our most active class is actually our Zumba class. We get about 30 women in our Zumba classes, and they enjoy it, and they're definitely keeping busy.
And how are you all doing in terms of how relaxed you feel about this situation? It sounds like you're being taken care of there, but obviously being stuck in one place for 14 days under these circumstances could potentially be stressful, could make you go a bit stir crazy. How are you all finding it?
Definitely, Bianca. I think we're all actually in complete understanding of spending our time here for 14 days. We're still taking major precautions. Half of us are still wearing our face masks, when we're in like public gatherings. But, you know, we all have our daily routines, you know, and I think that that's actually helping us. Some of the individuals have their laptops, but I guess they're doing their work. And they're just, you know, enjoying this beautiful California sun at the moment.
And Jared, are you still in touch with friends of yours that you know in Wuhan? And if you are, what's their experience like at the moment?
Yeah, you know, I'm sharing much grief right now, you know, thinking about, you know, the safety of myself, but leaving all my friends back behind. You know, I just want to, you know, send my prayers out to those of all my Chinese friends, because it's a serious matter, and I know that they're dealing with it as best as they can right now. And I hope everything is getting better back home.
Jared, it's been good to talk to you. We really appreciate your time. Jared Evans for us in California. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.